Hey guys, what's going on? James here, and this is a very, very special video because today I am joined by Jaydon Mickens. Jaydon Mickens, former two-time AFC Special Teams Player of the Week back in 2017, led Washington in receptions and receiving yards his junior and senior year, former college and now current teammate of Vita Vea. By the way, he did happen to play Tom Brady in the AFC Championship game, so it's some pretty awesome stuff. Jaydon, how are you doing today, man?
Man, I'm blessed and highly favored, man. I can't complain. How are you?
Good, man. Again, you know, we just talked here a minute before we went on here live, but you're the first Bucs player I have ever had on the YouTube channel. So I appreciate you. Not just the first Bucs player.
I appreciate you too.
You know, not just the first Bucs player, but the first NFL player, period, man.
That's awesome. So that means we got to set a standard.
That's right. That's right. And we're setting the bar high here, man. And, you know, one thing I did want to ask you about, just to, you know, get this first question here. Do you plan on making more music this off season?
I definitely plan on making more music. I thought about going into the studio tonight and getting some good stuff off my chest and, you know, talking some, having a good time doing it. I'm like, yeah, I'm definitely going to do that.
All right, because for those watching, you know, Jaydon just came out with his first song. It's Late Night Mission. You can see it on Instagram. There's going to be links to it down in the description and the comments of this video as well as all the links to Jaydon's social media. So go check it out. I've listened to it, Jaydon. I like it. It's good.
You know? I appreciate you. Thank you.
So I'm excited to hear you come out with more music, man. And I remember I saw you posting about it, about, you know, the quarantine and everything. And mm-hmm. Yeah, I think it's cool because it gives guys a chance to do stuff that they wouldn't normally have time to do.
Exactly.
You know, so
exactly.
Is music something you're passionate about?
Definitely. And it stems from, you know, getting ready for a football game, something that's happened to me in my life that, you know, I probably wouldn't be able to talk about or explain to somebody, and somebody may be going through it that is an artist already. Established artists or not established, and you know, I take that and I incorporate it with the things that, you know, that going on in my life, and we kind of have a bond from afar. So it's like when I'm listening to that music and it motivates me, it might motivate me from my childhood, my past, you know, growing up in the streets of LA, and the reason why, you know, I fought so hard to get where, you know, I wanted to go and get to where I am now. So music allows me to just come out with that type of energy and that type of, you know, effort to my life.
Yeah, you know, like obviously get some stuff off your chest and just kind of like put your thoughts on situations out there, right?
Definitely.
Yeah, I gotcha. And speaking of the LA area, that's obviously, you know, where you're from and everything along those lines. I remember you had a youth football camp out there, Out the Mud. Is that something you're still doing out there?
Yes, that's something I'm still doing. We took a year off. I had an injury. I was just out of it. I literally was out of it. I couldn't really move at all. You know, couldn't really take any time off. But, you know, coming to now, the quarantine and everything like that happened. But definitely this coming summer, we're going to, you know, revamp that, and we're going to do Out the Mud camp, and we're going to do it for the second time.
Awesome, man. And, you know, if there's a link to it, I'll definitely put that in there as well. So for anybody watching who's in the California area, you know, go check that out. Because, I mean, I love stuff like that, you know, being able to go out there and help out some of the younger kids and train them up and stuff like that, you know?
Yeah, we got to help the kids in Los Angeles, you know, especially specifically Los Angeles, because this is where I came from. But also in other states, because I wanted to honestly take it global, because it's like, you know, what else we're gonna do? I love to work out. I love to get better. You know, and if I have any type of knowledge that any, you know, young kid or, you know, even if it's somebody that's on my level that they want to obtain, I want to give that out, because this is a once in a lifetime opportunity that we were brought upon us. So, you know, I want to let them know that they can do a lot of things that they want to do.
Yeah, I think you made a good point there too. Is like getting other guys who, you know, around your age, and, you know, just having them be a part of it too. You know, it's really for everybody at the end of the day.
For sure.
You know, so let's get started here. First thing I want to talk about, Jaydon, is I want to talk about your journey to the NFL and specifically the Buccaneers. Okay. Mm-hmm. So coming out of Washington, you know, you went undrafted. You bounced around from the Oakland Raiders, then the Jacksonville Jaguars. You were there for a couple of years. Then at the beginning of 2019, you were with the Panthers, and then in late December, you ended up on the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. First thing I want to ask is, how did that kind of come about for the Buccaneers, you know, joining them? You know, were they interested in you throughout the season? Because I know you got added to the practice squad and then promoted to the active roster. So just kind of take me through that process, I guess, of this past season.
I actually, you know, was on the Panthers roster throughout the preseason. Mm-hmm. I literally signed the day of training camp, like the first day. So, you know, I broke my ankle coming out of the 2018 season against the Dallas Cowboys in October 14th, to be exact. I had surgery. People thought it was a sprain. People thought it was this. But I actually fractured my fibula, and I had to put a tightrope through my ankle, and I injured my interior deltoid ligaments. So I had a pretty rough injury that it took a lot of strength, a lot of courage, and a lot of heart to come back from. So once I got with the Panthers, I was with them. I showed them what I can do, but I just knew that it wasn't going to really last because, you know, it wasn't quite there. I was rushing it back. But I was able to maneuver and do what I do. But, you know, that night I was just in so much pain and trying to get it ready and all that type of stuff. So what I did was, you know, after that season, I didn't want to sign with anybody. And I just sat back. You know, I did different things. I started some businesses. I, you know, enjoyed my time off with my mom and my family. And I worked like crazy. I worked like crazy each and every day in Las Vegas to get back and to be, you know, that same powerful force that I was the years with Jacksonville. So after that, you know, at the end of the year came, I actually switched agents. And he was trying to put me in the best fit for my talent and my skill set and the person who I was. So, you know, the first call he made was to the Buccaneers, and they worked me out actually prior to even me signing with my new agent. They worked me out, and, you know, they said they liked me, but they needed somebody like for the right now. And my guy Ishmael was already with the team. So he knew the routes, he knew the assignments, he was already familiar with the culture. So, you know, he was able to play right away, you know what I mean, on the offensive standpoint with the injuries without a question. So once that was said and done, they had a spot on the practice squad. They brought me in. I had no problem with doing the practice squad. You know, I don't care how many AFC championships, whatever, player of the week. If the job needs to get done and they need to see what they need to see to put that person out on the field, I'm down. I'm all down for it. So they brought me in, you know, right off the couch, but I literally wasn't on the couch. I was like grinding like it was a season. 8 play drives, gassers, working out with helmets and shoulder pads, taking hits from bags. Yeah. So, you know, I was trying to get in the best. Okay, now you're ready to play football, which is impossible. But, you know, that's what I did. I came in. I did what I was supposed to do.
Yeah.
I'm not going to sit here and say, you know, oh, man, I went up top on this guy. I did that. I did what I was supposed to do. I showed them that, you know, this guy has a real talent and not just a talent where we're going to activate him, a talent where he can actually help us, you know, win football games, not only on offense, but on special teams. And, you know, it just took me getting in the playbook from the practice squad because we were going off cards and I knew what I knew when we were doing special teams. So, you know, I was using those little tricks and those little vet moves to my advantage to blow plays up. And, you know, once we got to the talks of, you know, they're thinking about activating you, just keep having great practices, I just got in the playbook. I got in the playbook as hard as, like, I wasn't on the phone. I wasn't on Instagram. Like, it was the first time where I really was, like, distant from everybody. And I was just studying plays. Me and Cyril Grayson was just studying plays. And guys like Scotty, you know, they'll help us out during the week. Jay Watt, Bashar Perriman, you know, even if it was plays, when we went out there, when I did get active and I was out there 33 plays, I'll be like, hey, what do I have on that? Do I bow that out? He's like, look, yeah, you're going to run that here and then come right there. So the guys were just helping and making us look good and making us look smooth and crisp out there. We didn't come away with the win, but, you know, it was football. But everything around just fell into place. And I think, you know, I'm in a great position where I am. But ultimately, it's up to me how far I go and how I rise with this team and trying to make that roster and helping this team, you know, ultimately get to a championship and a Super Bowl.
Yeah. So you're saying that it was more of a situation where it's like, you know, you felt you weren't ready to play throughout most of the 2019 season until you were fully healthy from that ankle injury. Because I wasn't ready. Yeah.
The coach brought me in multiple times. First time wasn't ready to work out. Like I just told him like, yeah, it's not. I'm not gonna look good. I'll run and then I'll probably limp a little bit.
Right.
And it just wasn't ready. And then they brought me in again and I was able to do a real workout and I shut it down. I went into mini camp, you know, but they, you know, I and they knew that it was like, you still, you know, you're not all the way there. You're doing what you're supposed to do, but we see you're not all the way there. So it's like, it's hard for them to take a chance, especially on the speed guy, a guy that's meant for a high velocity cuts and having an ankle injury like I had with a plate in my ankle. To give me that platform. So, you know, that's when I made the decision to get it all the way right. And when it was all the way right and I became the same beast I was,
yeah,
I was ready to go.
That's awesome, man. That is awesome. One thing I wanted to quickly ask you about was you just talked a lot about your mentality in terms of, like, as an undrafted player and kind of getting your mind right and battling for a roster spot. And just based on everything I've seen, you know, you have a phenomenal mentality as an NFL player, man. I'm dead serious about the work ethic, and then more so about the overall money aspect of it. You know, it's like, you know, at the end of the day, no paycheck's guaranteed. You know, I remember when I was, you know, seeing some of the stuff that, you know, back in 2017 when you had talked about it, you know, I was like, man, Jaydon's on some Marshawn Lynch levels of saving money in certain ways, you know, man, because like it, you know, I think you're very smart with how you use your money. So one thing I wanted to ask is kind of like, what's the mentality of an undrafted kind of free agent player? And like, do you still have that mentality coming into your fourth year in the league?
The mentality of an undrafted free agent, you know, at first hand is like coming in as a true freshman, like a freshman. If you're a first rounder, if you're a second rounder, you know, they'll give you crap, but you're not going to be treated like crap. You're going to get every chance to mess up and every chance to make one play or two plays where they say, okay, that's the first rounder we drafted, and we have to force them to be out there because that we spend money on them. As an undrafted player, you really have no chances to mess up. But if they like you and they think that you know, you can actually play, you know, you can mess up and they want to see what they can get out of you so you can, you know, possibly help the team in certain ways that, you know, they might want somebody else out of there. One play a day, two play a day, three play a day type of mindset, you know, when it comes to not only your football, but taking care of your body. You know, making sure we go to sleep, making sure we're drinking water, make sure we you know, we got, you know, everything about us in us that when we go out there, it's no hiccups. He's not getting tired. He's not cramping up. He's making every catch. We have to give them the hardest, you know, job to actually cut us.
Yeah.
You know, we can't allow it to be, well, he did this in this game. He dropped the ball here, but he did that. It cannot be in between. It has to be, this guy is a playmaker. He makes plays. It has to be on a Pro Bowl level, your mindset. Some people might not be playing on Pro Bowl levels, but they're doing Pro Bowl type things like being where they need to be, catching the ball where they need to catch the ball, getting the first downs, making the tackle on special teams, because that's ultimately how you're going to make it, because they already have their roster solidified besides a couple spots. And those couple back spots are mostly special team spots if you're not playing 30 to 60, 70 plays in a game. Really, the mindset, it has to be a dog-like mindset. It has to be, if you know, I get a cut, I'm going to rub some dirt on it type
right.
of deal.
Right.
You know, so it's different. It's different. It makes you better, though. That's what I love about it. It just makes you better, because at any given time, your spot can get taken. But at any given time, you can show that you can stake a spot, too.
Yeah,
that's what I love about it—the pressure, that back against the wall. That's going to make you play better. That's going to make you study more, study harder, so you can be better than everybody out there.
Yeah, because I guess at the end of the day, like it's—I mean, you're more motivated than most people, you know, because it's like you literally have to fight for every single thing you're going to be getting on this team, you know. Yeah. So I definitely get what you're saying there. You know, obviously coming into year four now, I mean, is that a mentality you still have moving forward here?
Oh, honestly, it's ramped up. It's times 10 right now. It's times 10 because I have to prove it. I have to prove it this year. You know, of course, I'm going to help the team and want to help the team and be that piece. But I want to be that piece where I control what I can control. Where if they look left and they see 85 or whatever jersey I'm wearing, we're good over there. We know what we're going to have over there. He's not going to get around that corner, or he's going, Jaydon's going to bust for a touchdown. Like, we're good. If we get that ball to him, blah, blah, blah. I want to have that confidence and that courage throughout not only my teammates, but the coaches and the higher-ups, general managers and the ownership. I need to have that confidence within everybody when that person is on the field.
Yeah.
We have the right guy.
Yeah. Because it's just like what you said. You know, you make these teams go, there's literally no way we can cut this guy because he just does everything right. You know?
Yeah. Then for any undrafted players, sorry to cut you off.
But you're good.
With that mentality and what you're doing, and you're making those big catches on those preseason games and practice and in those joint practices, 31 other teams see you.
Yeah. Yeah.
And they might not have that you, and they might want that you. And yeah. and you go from that team, and the next day, next week, you could be starting on Monday Night Football for a whole opposite team and have an incredible career there.
Yeah, because that's, you know, I think that's what a lot of people forget is just like, you're not just doing this for yourself to try and make one team.
Yeah.
31 other teams could be interested in you on a practice squad, on an active roster, you know, anything like that, you know.
Yep.
One thing I did want to ask, you just kind of alluded to it, is, you know, they just brought in a whole new batch of these undrafted wide receivers. I think there's around 5 or 6 of them. Have you been able to reach out to them and give them any kind of advice?
We haven't talked specifically on anything, but I did have to go on a Zoom meeting, a Zoom call where we have our meetings to talk about plays and things of that nature. And I just introduced myself, and I just gave, a good salute. So we haven't really got to talk, you know, like that. But, you know, if those guys, you know, want to reach out, we always here to help them, from me to Mike to, to Jay Frank, to anybody, Jay Watt, all those guys.
You know, you joined the team, you know, around week 17, like what we said, late December, I think, you know, December 18th, and then, you know, Christmas Eve, I think you were promoted to the active roster. One thing I wanted to talk about is, now you've had a little bit more time to become acclimated. You know, when you first got here, you had to super rush learning the playbook, and it's not an easy playbook to learn at the end of the day. No. You know, Bruce Arians' playbook and everything. But, you know, how has it been now that you've had more time with the team this offseason, you know, learning this offense that Bruce Arians and Byron Leftwich, you know, have, as well as just getting a feel for the team and the culture as a whole?
The feel for the team and the culture happened first day when I got there. You know, first day when I did my workout, you know, one of the DBs gave me some gloves to work out in because I didn't want to wear the ones I had.
Yeah.
So, you know, I knew from then on, and me and Vita being there, and then guys that, you know, had respect for me because they probably played against me when I was in Jacksonville on a different team. And, you know, all those guys really, you know, put their arm around me and everybody in that locker room. So that was, you know, first things first. But what was your first question?
The first part of it was, you know, becoming acclimated to the offense that Bruce Arians and Byron Leftwich have.
And acclimated to the offense, they just make it so fun. It's fun. It's so many ways that you can get open. And you know, I wouldn't say, you know, it's lackadaisical the way they allow you to play receiver, because it's not that. It's just that, you know, they allow you to, you know, take that extra head nod and get open and allow you to use your entire athletic ability to play at a high level of speed. And to have Coach Kev and Coach Randall L, you know, coach us up every day and trying to get us the best we can be. So when we get out there, we can play fast. We, you know, with that sauce, with that finesse on there, it makes you want to play football. You know, it makes you want to be a Buccaneer. It makes you want to be there. So I love every moment, you know, learning that playbook and figuring out the different varieties of how I can get better at it and learning different offensive geniuses like Byron Leftwich, you know, Arians. We got, you know, Tom Brady. Can't wait to talk to him and get in with him and find out what he's going. It's like you're a kid in a candy store.
Yeah.
If you play the sport.
There's so many reasons to be excited about, I mean, not just as a fan watching the offense, but to be a part of the offense as well, you know.
For sure.
One thing I did want to ask you is, obviously with the quarantine and things along those lines, what work have you been able to put in this offseason? And then have you been able to work out with any Buccaneers players so far this offseason?
I've been doing the schedule lifts that we have set in. by our strength and conditioning staff, and I've been on it every day. I actually got a workout here coming up in 2 hours. Okay. So I've been doing that, and then also my throwing, normal stuff that I'll do in the off season to stay right, and just you know, stretching, eating right, you know, and being smart is really what's kind of, but running, been running.
Yeah.
You got to be in shape yeah. with this offense, because you'll have a double post, then you'll have a stutter go. You know, you never know. You know,
yeah.
they it's a big play offense with Coach Arian. So just doing everything that they're telling us to do, and then using the veteran mindset that I have and know what's going to come about when we have to come to camp, and being ready, knowing we haven't had a real off season. So make it as off season OTAs as possible, so I can be ready.
Yeah. So have you been able to reach out to anybody, like, you know, Scotty or Jay Watt or anybody like that, in terms of getting workouts in?
We all Zoom call, but we all haven't worked out together. You know, I think Scotty and a couple of Mike and those guys, they worked out with Tom. Mm-hmm. And I know Jay Frank and Brian Mitchell, they been with Griff. So, you know, those guys, I know that this a couple workouts with each other, but I'm definitely going to get to Florida in the next week for a good week, so I can get a workout with those guys as well.
Yeah, because, like, you know, obviously, like, given the circumstances of the world right now, you know, not a lot of, you know, working together on certain things, you know. One thing I do want to mention real quick is having Tom Brady as your quarterback now. You played against him in the AFC Championship game, you know, and just kind of talking about that, what was your initial reaction when you saw that happening? You know, because not a lot of people thought that he was going to be on any other team, let alone the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, you know?
Yeah. My heart dropped, because it was like everybody coming out saying, man, if you would have went to the Patriots, man, Brady, you got Wes Welker, you know what I mean, the guy, Edelman, the guys that you could have been right there. And I'm like, man, that'd be crazy, you know? But yeah, you know, that's we dreaming. Nobody, you know, we're not gonna go to the Patriots, blah, blah. And he gets signed. And I'm like, nah, it's not real. Then my mom called me and she was like, you know, Brady signed. And we started getting text messages throughout the receiver. And it was just like, oh, it's real. So it's like, man, to have that opportunity, you know, he just brings the best out of us, whether he knows it or not. Like, he makes me, you know, stay up and study a little more, because, you know, if he gets a blitz and it's a high route, I gotta make sure I'm ready. So to earn his trust and to allow my game to grow and to do it the way that I envision doing it, by playing the football the right way, down the distance, just the love of the game, every, you know, 53 and a third inch wide of it. It's just, he makes it even more exciting and enjoyable and exciting.
Yeah, because it was just, you know, when I saw the news happen, I was like, oh, there's no way this is, you know, 100% confirmed. He's going to back out or something like this, you know, whatever's going to happen. But then it's like, no, it's officially official. And it's like, oh, my God. Like, this
is crazy.
It's like a fever dream. And then for them to go out and get Rob Gronkowski as well. I mean, you guys already had a good offense there, but now it's just gotten so much better with two legends now, you know?
For sure, and the best part about it is the guys that you may not hear about, where they are legends, but we have the mindset to be legends.
Right.
So, like what I always say, I'm never going to be perfect, but if I chase every inch of perfection, I'm gonna be in a damn good spot.
That's right. That's right, man.
So.
Yeah, you know, and then you have guys. Well, you have guys with your mentality as well, where it's like you come in and you just work stupidly hard, you know. Mm-hmm. So it's just like it's a really good time to be a Tampa Bay Buccaneer right now, you know.
Oh yeah, it's a great time.
One thing I wanted to ask you about real quick as well, you know, I wanted your thoughts on the rest of the quarterback room: Blaine Gabbert, Ryan Griffin, Reed Sinnott. Now I believe is in there as an undrafted quarterback. Just kind of getting your thoughts with them and working with them for this upcoming season as well.
Oh, with Blaine, you know, I heard about him. I seen him play, just, you know, on some college level, and then, and I hear he's a pretty great quarterback. I can't wait to work with him. I just can't wait.
Yeah.
And with Griff, you know, I had him on the practice squad already, so he made me look good in a lot of different areas. Cause I'm at, you know, you sometimes you have rookies and, you know, they don't know, you know, a back shoulder here and you know, throwing the ball low here to protect you and helping you getting open, you know, just with their, you know, quarterback mindset and allowing plays to develop naturally and, you know, can switch things up. So it was like, oh, man, you allowing us to run somebody else's offense, but throwing, incorporating our offense and it was just, it was, it's a mecca.
Yeah.
So those two guys, you know, they can be right in with it if anything, you know, they can play.
They can play if they need to, you know.
They can play.
Yeah, I got you. I got you, man. One thing I also wanted to talk about, and you did allude to, you know, both these guys earlier, Mike Evans and Chris Godwin, obviously having them is such a huge deal, a part of any wide receiver core. How have they mentored any of you guys in terms of picking up the offense and really working on stuff?
Well, when I got there last, Chris was there, Mike was still healing up. And he just gave us some good advice, some good tips. But, you know, as a vet, I really knew, you know, a lot of the verbiage, a lot of the concepts. He was just giving us specifics on everything so we could be as sharp as we can. And that was perfect for two people to come together and use their wits and get better with each other, plan or not plan. So, you know, now we're in the Zoom meetings and they both, you know, speak up and give great advice and let us know, you know, the things that can happen going on out there, things that we may have never seen before, whether you're a rookie or a vet, you know, having one of the best receivers of all time already, you know, in Mike. And then, you know, definitely coming up, he's going to keep having those years in Chris. So, you know, those guys helping us every day, every time we get on these Zoom calls, and really when we get together, it's going to be, you know, another level.
Yeah, it also sounds like too, it seems like you have some really good chemistry with guys like, you know, Ishmael, Cyril Grayson, Scotty Miller, Justin Watson. I'm just kind of talk, you know, real quick about how those guys have helped you out since you came to the Buccaneers late last year.
With Jay Frank, he actually was a lot of a quarterback for that last game.
Yeah.
Actually the game before that.
Yeah.
Because we were playing the Texans.
Yes.
And that was the week I got there. So he had to be Deshaun Watson. So that was my first three practices, and he had to be Deshaun Watson, and I had to be DeAndre Hopkins. So that's when the acting stuff started coming about, because, you know, we was having a good time out there. So, you know, we were making a lot of plays and you know, we happened to get active together, but we every day, me, him, and Cyril, you know, we knew we were going to play. So we were every day, three of us, boom, 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 every day. They'll FaceTime me and be like, hey, what you got on this? Bah, all right, bet, I'll talk to you later. And, like, you know, that type of chemistry. And then Scotty, you know, B. Mitch, those guys were all there. They were hurt at the time. But they were there helping us out anytime we needed help, watching film with us, showing, asking their questions. We're writing down their questions so we can know more.
Yeah.
And you know, Bashar Perriman, Jay Watt, they were actually on the field with us, like, huh, you got to be there, you got to be there, huh, a little out, a little further out. Like, they were actually, you know, if we needed it, which we were very well prepared once we go into that game, that they were there. You know, they wasn't going to leave us out. They'll literally stop the play for a second and be like, hey, man, blah, 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 all right, break. Like, we'll have our own huddle if we need it.
Right.
So they and Coach Kev, and the whole staff kind of put them in charge of that to, you know, if those guys need help, you know, help them up, coach them up, you know. And, you know, we were all vets. We all played in football games. We all played in big games. So it was even more smooth.
Yeah, because I think, you know, I think that's one aspect. Well, two aspects that people don't think about is just like that bond that the practice squad players get together, you know, because at the end of the day, you know, I don't think people understand where it's like, you know, as practice squad players, you have to mimic what the other team's trying to do for the most part, you know? So just kind of like, it can be fun, you know, just being...
I'm not going to lie. Practice squad actually got me better and made me feel untouchable, because it's like, I had to be Odell when I was with the Jaguars. I had to be Antonio Brown. I had to, like, so,
yeah.
You know, I'm getting these reps. I'm getting stutter goals. I'm getting curling goals. I'm getting, you know, stutter slants. Like, I'm doing all this. But not only that, I'm going against the players that you guys and fans or anybody love the most. I was going against Jalen Ramsey every day.
Right.
AJ Bouye every day. With Sean Smith was at the Raiders, you know. Just DB after DB after DB after DB. I'm going against the best ones.
That's right.
Out there.
That's right.
So it's like, how to Sean Gibson? How could you not be? How can you not think they're not good?
Yeah, yeah. And now obviously with the Bucs, you know, it's Carlton Davis, Jamel Dean, Sean Murphy Bunting, those guys who you're going up against, you know.
And that's who I went against the whole first week of practice.
I remember when Bruce said John Franklin, you know, we put him in at quarterback and he did pretty good, you know, back whenever against the Texans.
Yes, he did do very good. Very good.
Yes, that was interesting because, you know, I remember I was sitting there thinking, I was like, man, he's played cornerback, wide receiver, quarterback now. Like, he's just a freak athlete, man.
He's a freak.
You know, a lot of you guys on that practice squad are just freak athletes, you know?
I mean, I definitely could play some slot corner.
Yeah.
Kickoff, ran down on kickoff, got tackles on kickoff, gunner.
Yeah.
Like, so you have to be different. You got to be, you know some rules, know some tackling techniques. Along with catching the ball, I gotta take my gloves off when I'm on gunner because that's my catching gloves. I can't,
get ripped up.
And, yeah. You know what I mean?
Gotta be versatile, man. You know, I mean, that's part of
this football league. It's the more you can do.
Yeah.
The more you can do.
One thing I did want to talk to you about is obviously you came to the Bucs pretty quickly on. You know, you played in half the snaps, I think, the last game of the year, after only being here a week, which was awesome. There's definitely a battle for some of those backup wide receiver spots as well. Kind of wanted to get your thoughts on that real quick. But more importantly, I want to talk about the returning and special team spots as well. You know, being a punt gunner, being a returner, because you were a phenomenal returner with Jacksonville, man. You know, not even just, you know, the two-time AFC Special Teams Player of the Week, which was amazing, by the way, but just, you know, being able to be such a phenomenal returner for Jacksonville, you are definitely going to be battling for that spot as well. So just take me through both those position battles and kind of what it's like.
For the receivers, it's you know, help each other, make your plays, help yourself. Make every catch, know your hots, know your reads, know your assignment, know your alignment, and make big plays. And I mean, and bring it on. That's the only competitive nature. Who's making the most plays? Who's going to put the team in the best spot to win? And you only control what you can control. Right. So, you know, you can be. I didn't been on a lot of football teams where I, you know, were killing, no mistakes, this, that, that. And it's just, you know, I wasn't wrong with the Raiders. You know, Mari Cooper, we got Michael Crabtree. You know, Seth Roberts was in the slot. It was like, man, hey, you know, they had a punt returner and already that they had. So it's just you can control what you can control. But in the return game too, you can control what you can control. But I take that a little more personal because that what made me who I was. That what gave me the opportunity to still be in this league. Because they know I have that capability. You know, a lot of people should know that I have that capability in doing that. So when we're back there, that's what I do. I'm mad that I couldn't return one, and they were all inside the 10 in the last game because I wanted to really bust one for 70 or 80 and show that, you know, next year that this guy is serious. So, you know, that right there, returner, kick returner, I don't care if I'm the off returner.
Yeah.
We got to put on the show.
Yeah. 100%, man. And, you know, obviously, like, special teams, too. Like, that's something that a lot of guys take pride in, you know, being a phenomenal special teams player. That's one-third of the aspect of the game, you know?
I love teams.
Yeah.
Oh, I love teams.
Yeah, man. So, you know, it's just, like, I was a little sad, too, that you didn't get a chance to return. I imagine that's something they've already talked to you about, like, hey, you're going to be up there for returning duties.
Mm-hmm.
That'll be awesome, then, man. One thing I did want to ask you, because you didn't do it a lot in college in terms of returning. I think you had around 20 or so returns one of your college years. But what made you become such a good return man in the NFL?
Honestly, I didn't do no punt return. I probably was back there like twice and had a fair catch or two. But after that, my freshman year, it was all kick returns. And,
right.
You know, I had a couple plays in the offense, and that's how I earned my true freshman being a kick returner and returning all the kicks. So I ain't never scored. Dang, that's crazy.
I didn't mean to bring that up.
Yeah, dang. I just thought about that. Oh, I suck. But when I got to the league, you know, and they let us know, like, man, we got a lot of receivers that's already signed up. Like, what's the next thing you can do? All right, let me see. Gunner. I was okay at Gunner when I first came in. I can do Gunner now.
Right.
But I didn't really know. Like, it's a lot of technical stuff. You know, back drives, you can't go too far back. You know, when they get the hands on you, what to do. So you had to learn that stuff. But when I got to punt return, I had a problem with catching the ball, like, right before it hits the ground. I was like, man, he has great hands. But, fuck, I'm scared when he's back there because it's just like he's going to return it and make it look good. But it's like he's catching it so low. So Brad Seaton, the positive thing he did was be on my ass. Like, he was on me. Up there. Let's go, 19. Let's see what you got. Come on.
Right.
Oh, he almost dropped it. Yeah, I know. So he was getting me right. But once I started to be better at it and get better at it and learn how the trajectory of the ball, it changes. So if it's a left-footed punter, the ball's going to fall to your right. If it's a right-footed punter, the ball's going to fall to your left. Right. Even if it's looking like it's going to fall the opposite way. If you stand right on the side, it's going to turn that spin, hit that wind, and come right to you. And understanding the net punt of the punters. Is he a 43-yard net punt? Look at the film. The ball hitting at 41, 42, 45 every time. So yeah. Stand at 45 yards and it won't go over your head. You can come right to it unless he get a bomb. And if he gets a bomb, go back, catch it, and you got so much he outkicked his coverage. So you're going to get 10 yards of return. And if you get 10 yards of return and have a 10-yard average, you're damn near pro. You're a pro bowler.
Yeah.
So just understanding and learning those things and talking to a big-time returner, one of the best returners probably ever in the history of the league, Cordell Patterson.
That's right.
You know, on kick returns and when he was with the Raiders, when I was with the Raiders, and talking to other punt returners like Jalen Richard, because me and Jalen Richard at the Raiders were competing for the punt return job.
Yeah.
But he was catching them so clean, and then he buzzed one in the game and he was killing that running back. It was like, man, Jaydon, we would love to have you right there, but it's like this guy, he has more value right now.
Yeah.
So I was like, all right, that's good, you know. So, you know, me and those guys still talk and still talk about returning, and we'll just sit up. If literally me and Jalen was, and he came to L.A., and we just was throwing the ball high as we can, and looking like catching them clean.
Yeah.
And just playing around. And you build those relationships. Marquette King, I talk to him all the time about his punting, about this. He's giving me tips like, man, if he stands there, he's going there, but this might fall here. If it comes out, it's going to shank that way. So it'd be like, oh, if you shank it, oh, I'm going to just stand right there. It's going to come right to me. So having those talks gets you game-like and game-prepped, and it's amazing.
Well, you've learned from some of the best. You know, Cordell Patterson, one of the best returners. Marquette King, one of the best punters, you know, in a long time.
Yeah.
You know, Jalen Richard, too. The reason I asked you is because I know, like, a lot of people, they really do take special teams for granted. You know, they really do. I'm a big special teams guy. And you just from you explaining, there's so much more that goes into returning the ball than just, oh, they just stand there and catch it. It's not even close, you know?
Yeah. Now for me, yeah.
Yeah.
Because I just, you know what I mean? I just kick it. I got you.
Yeah.
But still. Still got to have my elbows in tight. Still got to have my platform right. Still got to see the trajectory. You know what I mean? You still got to have those things, feet square, this square, you know? So, you know, you don't want to get out there and it's like, oh, man, he's great, great returner. And that big game and the big championship game,
Yeah, I know.
That can happen.
I know, man. And is it going to be something where you're going to be trying to do both kick returning and punt returning for the Buccaneers?
I'm willing to do anything they see me as best as, but kick return and punt return is definitely on my agenda to have and to make. You know, I'm not saying I'm going to be the starter. No, what I'm saying is when I'm back there, I plan to put on a show for my teammates so we can win ball games, whether it's returning for a touchdown or getting decent yardage and field position and not letting it go inside the 10, blocking somebody. Being that great teammate, so I can earn that spot.
Well, Jaydon, the last thing I want to ask you here before we go ahead and finish off this is kind of your expectations for the upcoming season. obviously you have a championship mentality. You've been to an AFC championship game before. You've won multiple playoff games before with the Jacksonville Jaguars, you know, coming off that injury here, you know, that you suffered back in 2018, coming, you know, through 2019, still were a little bit banged up. Now you're fully healthy. You're ready to go, you know, being a phenomenal special teams player, showing what you can do at the wide receiver position as well. I just kind of want to get, you know, what you're expecting yourself to bring for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers this upcoming season, kind of your expectations.
My expectations, what I expect to have the best Jaydon Mickens out there that has ever been. If any highlights you ever seen, any good plays, bad plays, whatever, I'm ready to one up all that. I'm ready to really be on a Pro Bowl mindset and Pro Bowl level. But it's going to take that actual action, and that's up to me. But that's the mindset I'm having. That's what I want to bring to this football team, and I want to be the best athletes, you know, with the ball or without the ball in the NFL.
Yeah, I agree 100%,
man. This year.
Right.
This year, and for however long I'm playing, consistently, and that's what I'm working towards.
Are you going for that that special teams captain's patch this year?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I'm going for any captain's patch I can get. But at the end of the day, I'm just going to play ball.
Yeah.
You know, that's going to come. That'll come.
Yeah, absolutely, man. Well, hey, Jaydon, seriously, thank you so much for being on here. You know, first ever Tampa Bay Buccaneer to ever be on the YouTube channel. It means a lot to me, man. So thank you.
Appreciate you, man. Thank you for having me.
Of course, man. And before we head out here, is there anything else you want to get off your chest in terms of talking about certain things? Anything you want to plug? Obviously, I'll have links to your Instagram and your music and things along those lines, and to the youth football camp as well. You mentioned some businesses and things along those lines earlier. Is there anything else you want to talk about here and just kind of mention?
I have a French bulldog, exotic bulldog business that we breed French bulldogs. So I have a lot of those. Out the Mud Exotics is the name. Just how it's spelled, Out the Mud Exotics on Instagram all together. And man, I'm just ready to play football, man. And I just want to tell everybody to love everybody, no matter the race, no matter, you know, the blood, who you know. Love everybody. Be positive. Be encouraged. And, you know, play to win at all times.
Yeah, I agree 100%, man. And I'm excited to see you this upcoming season as a returning ace for this team, as a special teams god, essentially. You know, and just overall being a phenomenal player for this team, Jaydon. So thank you so much, man.
I appreciate you. Thank you.
Of course, man. So anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Hope you all enjoyed. Let us know what you think about this entire interview down in the comments section below. And yeah, it's just been awesome. Don't forget to follow Jaydon on all the social medias. Go check out his music. Go check out the French Bulldogs and everything along those lines. It's a lot of awesome stuff. And guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Hope you all enjoyed. But until the next video or the next live stream, we'll see you guys in the next one. But until then, and as always, guys, goodbye for now. And go Bucs.